is Chaz Ebert. I am here at the Bahamas International Film Festival. I think it's their 11th edition, and I was invited as a tributee, which I'm very honored to receive a tribute from the festival. Part of the tribute consists of showing my film, Life Itself, which is the documentary about my husband, Roger Ebert. It was directed by Steve James, the acclaimed director who also directed Hoop Dreams, The Interrupters, and other very, very great documentaries. Magnolia Pictures is distributing the film, and CNN Films is also one of the producing partners. The film is executive produced by Martin Scorsese and Steve Zaillian, who wrote Schindler's List. I'm happy to be at the festival to discuss many aspects of the film. Number one, beginning with Roger's contribution to the film industry, and particularly the independent film industry. He was a champion of independent films for many, many years, and in the film, some of the directors who give him credit for giving a boost to their careers are Errol Morris, Werner Herzog, Gregory Nava, Ramin Barani, and I might add Ava DuVernay, who just made history as being the first African-American woman director to win a nomination for a Golden Globe. Roger, my husband, also actually gave a boost to Scorsese's career, and he also is part of the film. As he talked about getting his first review from Roger in 1967. I think that's the year, well, that's the year that Roger became a film critic, and I think it's the year that Scorsese made his first feature film, Who's That Knocking at My Door? And Marty talks about how he got the review and carried it around in his pocket. And in fact, in the next year, he said he was still carrying the review around in his pocket when he was in Italy and he was reading it, because I think Roger said Scorsese would be our next Fellini.
Nice.
In 10 years. And Marty said, do you really think it will take that long? So, and over the years, I think they developed an affection for each other and a respect for each other's work, because they both grew up in this industry together. Steve James did a magnificent job. And one of the reasons I think the film is being so well received is because it is not just a nonstop congratulations. And actually, Roger wouldn't have wanted to participate in a film that would be that. Roger said, make this film about the man, not the icon, and that's what Steve did. It is a warts and all portrayal, because Roger was not perfect, as, you know, I don't know anyone who is, and it shows some sides of him that may be a little surprising to some people, and some aspects of his life that may be a little surprising to some people. So no, it's not just a nonstop congratulations.
Right.
It is a very open, transparent, and layered, interesting portrayal. Life Itself started on the festival circuit in January at the Sundance Film Festival. And it was a great, great evening for us, because there was something that Sundance allowed us to do that had never been done at a festival before. The same night that it was being screened in Sundance, it went out over the internet it was streamed to followers. The producers had done an Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign, and one of the perks was to see the film at home the same night that it was screened in Cannes.
Life.
That had never been done before. Life Itself, Roger would have been so thrilled, because he was a very big proponent of streaming and technology and the internet, but more importantly, making a community of it. So it was a community of film goers who were watching the film the same night. I do remember that we also screened the film at the at Ebertfest, our own film festival, which is the Roger Ebert Film Festival. It used to be called the Roger Ebert Overlooked Film Festival down in Champaign, Urbana. Urbana is Roger's hometown, and in about 1999, we started a festival at the University of, in conjunction with the University of Illinois. And so, of course, that was a very special screening because it was, you know, at the Roger Ebert Film Festival is called Ebertfest, and so it was very poignant to have the film screen there. We've been on to many other film festivals. Cannes was a big one because Roger spent, you know, a great deal of his career going to the Cannes Film Festival every single year until he couldn't do it anymore, and so Cannes was very important to him. Roger was one of the American critics who introduced the Cannes Film Festival to American audiences, and so it was important to him to write about Cannes every year, and to he was a big proponent of world cinema, and so he discovered, so that's why Cannes was very important to him, and it was just beautiful to have the film presented at the Cannes Film Festival. Steve James took it to the documentary film festival in Sheffield, England. Yes. He also took it to a film festival in, I think there's a big documentary film festival in Zurich as well. Of course, IFA, the Netherlands, everywhere this year. I think the film festival circuit has been very important in making people aware of the existence of the film, but also giving the audience and filmmakers alike a chance to discuss aspects of the film that when you watch it alone at home you can't get. You know, one of the things that the film does very well is to show you a little bit about the relationship between Roger and his TV partner Gene Siskel. They actually invented the genre of the movie review show. There had never been anything like that before their show started on public television in 1975. And they were a TV partnership for about 24 years until Gene Siskel's death in 1999. One of the things that they did very well is they took an entire representation of films, whether they were big Hollywood movies, independent films, foreign films. Roger and Gene would talk about them in a way so that the viewing audience, the regular audience at home, could understand it. And they educated audiences with their show. They talked about the difference between black and white films, why they seemed timeless, color films and colorization. They talked about issues like, you know, developing character and screenwriters. They talked about African-American cinema and why a diversity in cinema was so important to the continuation of the film world. They were just, on some of the issues, really ahead of their times, and in some they would bring the audience along with them. And one of the things that Roger did, in addition to the show, is he attended film festivals regularly. He thought that it was really important to stay on top of what was happening, what are the new trends coming down, what are the films that, you know, maybe he could help a little more with, you know, by writing about them. And he felt that part of the duty of the film critics was not only to tell the audience what he felt was good or bad, but what was something just making them, you know, spotlighting certain films that may need a bigger audience. I am doing a lot of things to try to maintain my husband's legacy because he left a beautiful, long body of work. He began interviewing movies in 1967, so he has over probably about 46 years of reviews, as well as other articles about film festivals and treatises on different aspects of film. So those are things that we will want to make sure that we maintain and make available to the public, both at RogerEbert.com, and we have some other ways coming up to do that. He also wrote three books of great movies called the Great Movie Series, and I think there are 100 movies per book, and he was halfway in to the fourth edition of the Great Movies, and we've been approached to make a Great Movies TV series, and so that's one of the things we may do. There are other things. There's a musical coming out about Roger in Chicago, produced by the Black Ensemble Theater. They were very much impressed by his inclusion of diverse filmmakers in the industry, particularly African-American filmmakers. But they said that one of the things that Roger did in his insistence upon inclusion of diverse filmmakers in the film industry, but also his talks and articles about social justice, is participate in racial healing. And so they have I'm talking to the playwright Jackie Taylor, and actually will be working with her on this musical that they're doing, and it's called The Black White Play. That's the name right now, that's the working title. And it comes out in September of 2015. There are other things in the works that people have approached me about. And so there, you know, I will be very busy over the next few years.
Wonderful. Tell us about the dates of the Ebertfest, remind me.
The Ebertfest, Roger Ebert Film Festival, is in Urbana-Champaign, Illinois, April 15th through the 19th in 2015.